take a look at the winners and the losers of the season. First off, bring up some props to Mike Porter, the freshman of the year. He's not just you speculate when he'll go in the draft. He will get drafted. He's entering the draft. He's got the tournament to play first. Stan came in and averaged 30 points a game. Got him a goal. He averaged a double double and a block a game. So, I mean, can it translate into the league? You know, but I mean, that's pretty impressive feat in itself. I think his draft stock can go up depending on what he does in the tournament. I don't think it could go down. I mean, if he comes out and has a bad game and they lose, I don't think his draft stock can go down. He averaged a double-double. Obviously, the talent's going to change high caliber in the league, but you got to take a chance on a guy who dominates this league like that because, you know, the sky's the limit with him. He's got North Carolina State where they're at. They got a good point guard, a good rock distributor in Martin Bent. Chad Perry, he's a senior. Sheik Silva, he's a senior too. A sophomore. Let's take a look at the teams that are resting in peace. Give a moment of silence to the ones who couldn't be here with us today in the NCAA tournament. That would be Miami made it? Florida made it? What the hell? Check this out. FSU and LSU. Okay, a quick glance at the games we're going to cover. We're going to cover FSU and LSU. And probably the sequel. We're going to cover North Carolina State, Texas. Miami under the 17th. We're not going to cover that game. Cover the postmortem. We're going to cover the Kansas and Ohio State. That's going to be a good matchup. Again, teams that could not make it. Texas A&M came in at 9-8. They said, oh, you can do it. They played way better. They lost out. They're gonna have to sit it at home this year. Really sucks for them. Ole Miss coming at 8-9. They are not gonna make it. They're gonna lose a lot of seniors too, I think, this year. Cole Pepper, I think, might be a senior. Alabama Crimson Tide. We kind of speculated last year when they lost their best player to the draft that they wouldn't be as good this year, but they came close. Came close, just a little bit shy of the mark. They're not gonna be in the tournament this year. The Red Raiders, not gonna be in the tournament this year. Arkansas Razorback, not gonna be in the tournament this year. Tar Heels, not gonna be in the tournament this year. Tennessee Volunteers, 6-11 was their final record. They're not going to be in the tournament this year. Oklahoma Sooners, Arizona Wildcats, the Raging Cajuns, obviously, with the worst record in the conference. Not going to be in the tournament. 1-7 at home. Wow. But you know how it is, you know, with schools, you got to die off, man. Year in, year out, and you win and you lose. You're going to ride and die for your school, but they got to do better. So these teams will try again next season. They'll try to recruit as best they could. But as a rule for the establishment of this league, the teams that make the tournament get better deals on the recruits. Okay. So that makes it hard, you know. It's not going to be an inverted draft order where the worst teams come at the top. If you make the tournament, you get a bonus for your recruits. The recruits will be more likely to play for you with a successful organization if you make the tournament. You see Oklahoma State here, they on the road. They're going to bring that into it. They're going to bring that momentum into the tournament. We lost to them this year. They got it. Just a quick glance at the teams that is already in it. We got plenty of time to focus on them. Right now, I want to look at the teams that we forgot about in about 5 minutes. Villanova 8-9. Host California. They really wanted to be there. Virginia Tech. A team that was not really expected to make it, but they almost did. 8-9 was a pretty good season for them. Next season, they expected they probably might make it with the progression of their star player who's going to come back for another year. But he'll definitely be a draft topic next year. Obviously, this year it's Michael Porter, but Syracuse 8-9, Oregon Ducks 7-10. It'll be interesting to see how they recruit. We got Zion Williamson. You know, they just got to put some pieces around them. They should be, you know, they can go from this year not making a tournament to next year winning the tournament. They could just recruit, you know, a good piece or two. West Virginia, you can disregard the Morgantown part. It's West Virginia 6-11. They're not going to make the tournament. Virginia Cavaliers is not going to make the tournament. Kentucky Wildcats 4-13. Very disappointing. That was the worst. Obviously, even the recruits probably not going to be able to help them. Gonna hurt their recruiting chances this year, but I mean, it's still gonna be interesting to cover it because it's just an unexpected recruit that was gonna go to a school that was doing better, you know, all of a sudden turns around and decides to go there. A little moment of silence for these teams. Like the efforts, I'm gonna have to watch the tournament from the house. Let's look at the tournament. What an upset that would be if they could. And the FSU, LSU. Oh, definitely got a game on the hand. We'll get to see Michael Porter firsthand before he Texas will try to make it his last game in a North Carolina State uniform. Real tough. He could win the games, especially if he has a good night. Miami, but Miami's just excited. Happened. All of Michigan. They're relevant. Plays will definitely believe that. Yeah, they definitely think they're a better team than what they came in at. The record shows they let a couple games get away from them. By time. Lost and you're gone.